For years, there were only two major aircraft manufacturers, Airbus and Boeing, which created a duopoly for medium-sized and wide-body planes. Especially in the medium-sized market, it all came down to the Airbus A320 and Boeing 737, newer variants. Now that is changing as Chinese company COMAC, which is short for Commercial Aircraft Corporation of China, introduced COMAC C919, a direct competitor for Airbus A320 and Boeing 737 family aircraft. COMAC also wants to compete directly with Airbus A350 and Boeing 787 and create a wide-body jet. So watch until the end as I will tell everything later. But first, let's answer the question about what is so unique about this made-in-China jet. After all, the first COMAC-made aircraft, ARJ-21, is rather a failure with only 250 orders in total, except one from Chinese carriers. ARJ-21 is also a regional jet, which is a completely different market with only one important manufacturer, Embraer. This plane has also been flying commercially since 2016, and I'm pretty sure almost nobody heard about it. C919 is a completely different story, as it has already gained more than 1,000 orders, at least according to COMAC. The aircraft itself is a direct competitor to Boeing 737 MAX and Airbus A320neo. It even has the same type of engine, the CFM LEAP-1C. C919 started regular commercial operations on May 28, 2023, with a China Eastern Airlines flight between Shanghai Hongqiao Airport and Beijing. Later, the aircraft appeared at the Singapore 2024 Air Show, where it was the first Chinese-produced aircraft that made its debut on foreign soil. Here, the plane shocked the aviation world, as Boeing and Airbus finally started to have competition for the first time since the time when Boeing purchased McDonnell Douglas, the manufacturer of the famous MD-80, in 1997. COMAC claims that C919 has comparable fuel costs to A320neo and 737 MAX, but we are unlikely to see whether it's true, as all operators of this aircraft are from China. The Chinese manufacturer is, however, rather optimistic and expects the demand for passenger aircraft in the Asia-Pacific market to increase over the next decades to almost 10,000 planes and sees an opportunity to gain significant market share here. The next Chinese aircraft that could revolutionize the aviation market is COMAC C929. This plane is very interesting, as previously it was meant to be a joint venture between a Chinese manufacturer and Russian United Aircraft Corporation. Due to this, it was known as CR-929. However, following the tensions and disagreements between the partners and uncertainties linked to international sanctions on Russia, COMAC is continuing the program independently of the Russian company. The jet itself will be a direct competitor to Airbus A350 and Boeing 787 Dreamliner. Again, these two manufacturers haven't had any competition in the wide-body market since the end of McDonnell Douglas and its MD-11 program. The C929 is intended to fit from 280 passengers in a three-class configuration to 440 in one-class configuration, depending on the version. The plane will be able to fly up to 14,000 kilometers, or around 7,500 nautical miles. C929 will have a similar, modern, and technologically advanced cockpit as the C919, which is, however, suspiciously similar to the Airbus A220 and A350. The biggest problem with C929 is currently the engine, as since the Russians pulled out of the project, it still hasn't been developed, and the Chinese company will have to rely on Western companies such as Rolls-Royce or General Electric. In May 2024, COMAC announced the start of works on an even larger C939, a twin jet with around 400 seats and a 7,000 nautical miles range. It will be a competitor to Boeing 777, and specifically its newest version, the 777X. All of COMAC's C900 series aircraft are or will be built from composites, which are also used in the newest Airbus and Boeing aircraft. Chinese-made planes are also significantly cheaper than Western-made jets, and that matters to smaller carriers. However, both manufacturers are not afraid of COMAC and don't treat it as a real competitor. The first reason for this is certification. COMAC aircraft are only certified in China and are thus unable to fly in Western countries. That may change, as at the beginning of 2024, Chinese manufacturer announced that it wants to get an EASA certificate with the help of the Chinese Aviation Authority. Unfortunately for China, the current geopolitical tensions make this situation very unlikely to happen. The second argument is the supply chain issues. Airbus and Boeing's representatives say that Chinese jets will face the same problems as they face, since it still relies on Western technology, including engines and avionics. Even the help of the Chinese government will not change much, as this is a global problem. The final reason is confidence. Not only Western airlines, but also well-known Asian carriers from Japan, Thailand, and Singapore are rather reluctant to order Chinese-made planes because they don't trust COMAC, which doesn't have a lot of experience in aircraft manufacturing. The airlines are also afraid that people who are not from China will refuse to embark made-in-China jet. And since C919 is still not widely used, there are problems with getting spare parts and proper maintenance. So will China revolutionize the aircraft market? In the long term, probably yes. But now, Boeing and Airbus have nothing to worry about, as their duopoly in the medium and large aircraft market will continue until at least the end of the decade. However, once Chinese planes will gain popularity on the international market, they will have to adjust their position. Thanks for watching, and as always, like and subscribe to my channel, as it helps me to produce new ones that are going to be very interesting.